We got a new tool to test out. Let's get it out of the box, see what it is. Oh boy. You know what that is, right? Well, get the sleeve off of here, see what it looks like. You guys know I like to do tool reviews once in a while, especially something cool like an inductive heater. I have similar tools from other brands to compare it to, but oh wow, that looks pretty nice actually. This is a insulating sheathing or cover that if it touches something, it won't totally destroy the copper leads. Instructions. This has the manual knobs that you screw in when you want to lock this. Some of them are automatic, some clip in, some screw in. This one has the screw in knobs. We'll get this thing ready. Comes with quite a few assortments and stuff, small and large bolts. So we're definitely going to try this thing out, see how it works. It looks good in appearance, except for my, I don't have it in a proper location. But plastic's got a little texture, so it shouldn't be too slippery in the hand. Power button. Alright. The one I have was about four times as expensive as this and didn't come with half of these. I had to buy them separate. And it was $90 just for these four or five different add-on probes. These are universal. You can bend them however you want. All we need now is rusty bolts to get it done. Stay tuned. We're going to try out this KKSevens KS01. We have got a frozen tie rod jam nut. Someone else has boogered it up pretty bad. I have done a little bit of it trying with my adjustable and with a monkey wrench and a pipe, and it will not turn. So we're going to use the inductive heater to heat this nut, see if we can get it to turn that way. I'm going to use one of these universals. These are great if I could get the tie rod end off and heat the nut on the inner tie rod, but since I can't do that, I'll wrap this around one loop and then install it in the tool, and we'll come back seeing how it does.
Get that positioned pretty well. I plugged it in and the fan turned on inside it, but I'm not pushing any buttons. Makes me a little nervous. I do not want to connect this if it's live, so I will unplug it, get these probes in place. I wish the carrying case left you room to leave the knobs in the tool, but it doesn't. You have to take them out every time, which not too big of a deal. It should stay where it's at. I got those knobs pretty tight on the probe. Kind of strange that the fan turns right off, but pushing the power button, we'll see how it does. Smoke is a good indication that it's getting hot. I don't think I'm shaking that much, but it looks like I am. I'm trying not to let it touch. We don't want it to touch the metal. It's actually supposed to be banging atoms around under magnetism to make heat. Someone call me? I keep hearing my voice. Good morning. was hoping it would glow orange, but that has not happened. I'm gonna unplug it. I'm gonna try to see if I can turn that nut now. I don't know if it got hot enough. Rock solid jammed. Might have to get the blue wrench if this won't get hot enough. I'll give it one more try. Touch that probe for sure. Once it's got heat in it, it'll take a while to cool off, so. Tell you what, it definitely got it hot. Yay, success. Not bad. It turns, so it is not happy about it at all, but a little inductive heater got it hot enough that we broke it loose. The nut's already been destroyed, like I said, someplace else. He told us they couldn't align it. I'm not gonna name the franchise that couldn't do it, but you gotta have an inductive heater like that one. That's all.
Okay, I got the lock nut tightened back up. Should be cool enough to remove.
These universal ones I only use when I have to, because they do have a lifespan. You're bending and unbending them, and eventually they're gonna break and get new ones. But this comes with quite a selection of them, so.
As you saw earlier in the video, that was pretty. A lot of them you have to buy these all separately, and this is around $130, $150, I believe, but there'll be a link in the description for it if you're interested. The only thing kind of weird to me is that the fan turns on when you plug it in. I wish the fan started when you push the button, but that's okay. We'll deal with it. It worked. That's most important.
Ooh, boy. So thanks for watching. Torque the like button on your way out, if you will. Hope I see you in another video, because you're awesome.